now we fought before, and I had trained with him, and I had known him. I just knew it was going to be really tough, and it was just as tough as I thought it was. And that fight, having that loss, I think was better for me in a way than a victory, because I think a victory at that point, having gone 4-0, won a belt, I think I may have thought I was better than I was if I had won that fight. And now, seeing where I was to where I've been now, that I've just been training and trying to get all my skills up for the whole last year and become the best I can at every part of fighting, mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually, all of that, I think that the loss paid off for me, because I think if I had won, I think I would have been somewhat complacent to my actual skill level. And looking back on that fight, I've come a long way, so I look forward to getting back in there and seeing how far I've come. Freestyle Fitness, man, he's had my back since day one, since before even there was a reason to have my back. I think he's just a really giving, one of the best people I've ever known. He's all about making everybody around him better, and he's just been there from day one, training me with my strength and conditioning, cardio, just various drills and techniques and strength and power and endurance. And he's got a voice that keeps you going. He just seems to know what to say at what time and how to say it, just to make you get the extra bit out of you that you never had before. Empire Jiu-Jitsu in Yuba City, which is where my first opponent I ever fought, is where he trained at. So it feels full circle now to be training over there and be welcomed over there to do jiu-jitsu. Everywhere in Red Bluff, we started out of Sam's Barn, which has been my favorite place I've ever trained in my entire life. It just had a aura to it, and there's a kind of stigma about it. You know, I don't know. Like, you could go in there and there'd just be a dead mouse on the mat sometimes, and you brush it off, spray it down, and that's just where we're training. You know, we're training in a barn on mats, with punching bags, two walls, and when we're going out there and we're putting on shows every time we fight. I mean, training out of the barn, you know, racked up quite a few wins. But that's where we started training in Red Bluff. Sam trains us out of Psycho Fitness. Sam knows all these people and has these relationships with them where we can train wherever we want to, pretty much. Makes it great, and the fact that they have their doors open to us to train there and are supportive of us, and mainly Rocky. Like, Rocky has a really good relationship with them at that gym. Psycho Fitness is raw. It's a raw gym to train at. You go there and you know you're gonna have hard sparring. You know you're gonna have some hard rolls. The cage is small. It's got four corners, so you can get cornered real easy. You get lots of good cage training in a lot smaller environment than you would fight in a real cage. what I like the most about that. When I come out to fight, I feel like I have part of all of us in me as the warrior that I am. So when I go out, I feel like I got Sam's strength. You know, I feel like I have my coach's strength and my coach's wisdom. I feel like I have Jesse's speed and jujitsu abilities. I feel like I have Alex's toughness. I feel like I have, you know, Cole's endurance. I try to, you know, try to tell myself I have all those things because I train with all those guys. And you become your surroundings, and I believe they rub off on me. So I feel like I fight bigger than myself. I feel like I fight as a unit, you know, of everyone that has made me what I am to that point. And I feel like it all comes out on fight night. And I can't wait.
You be anything you want. Just keep going, 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 going. Now don't stop here, nigga. Stop here, nigga. Yeah.